Hello, Postas. My name is Visalakshi. Now I am going to do OPOS Kaju Katli. Okay. So let's get started by weighing the ingredients needed for the sugar syrup hack. So we need 200 grams of sugar. Okay. So that's 200 grams of sugar. 60 ml water, that's quarter cup. Okay, 60 ml water, a tablespoon of ghee, tablespoon of ghee, will be about like 10 to 15 grams. Okay, so this is the basic sugar syrup measures. I'm going to take this out. I'm going to close the piece, magic pot, on the pressure baker. Now, before we start, I'm going to show you the measurements of the main ingredient. That's the cashew powder. Okay, so we're going to take 180 grams of cashew powder. You can use any nut powder of your choice. You can use a mix of almond and cashew. You can use just cashew. You can use just almond or walnut or pista or whatever. Okay. Any nut powder. So we are going to take 180 grams. Right, that's 180 grams of it's not visible. You see the number now? Let me just move this. Okay, 180 grams of cashew powder. Let's take this out. I'm going to keep the magic pot closed, and you're going to cook on high for 4 whistles. Alright, now let me show you the recipe. So this is the recipe I'm following. In a bowl, take 180 grams of powdered cashews. Now I have blended this in my house. So if you have access to store-bought cashew powder, that's fine too. That will be finer, and the one which I have right now, it's slightly coarser. In a 2-liter pressure baker, add 200 grams of sugar, 60 ml water, 1 tablespoon ghee. Now this formula is the standard sugar syrup. Okay, cook on high for 4 whistles. Now for katli, we'll go anywhere from 2 to 4 whistles depending on the main ingredient that we add. Now if it is for milk powder, we'll stop with 2 whistles. If it is for nut powder, we might want to go for 3 to 4 whistles to get that desired texture. Cook on high for 4 whistles, release pressure, add the sugar syrup to the bowl containing the cashew powder. Mix well and spread it on a greased platform. Let cool, and when it is mildly warm, we'll cut into desired shapes. Now this is the basic template for any nut based katlis. Okay? The difference between katli and burfi is, katli is the thinner version. So the burfi is slightly harder version. The texture also varies. Katli is kind of a soft, pliable dough, whereas burfis are slightly harder and thicker, so not really easily pliable. So, and it shouldn't be too hard, that it needs to be broken apart to chew. The difference. The main difference is the pliability and the texture. Katli is thin, usually thin. You can make it into thick katlis. That's not an issue. But the sugar syrup that is needed for the katli is slightly less stronger than what is needed for the burfi. Now I'm going to grease the platform which I'm going to spread the dough on. Let me just grease. So we're about to get the first whistle now. Now while mixing the dough, you may add a teaspoon or two of ghee if you want. If you find the dough to be dry, you could also add a bit of milk if you want. A teaspoon or two, okay, not more than that. Yeah, so that is the first whistle. So we should be getting our whistles in about 3 minutes. That's the second whistle, 253. Third whistle, 2:53. That's the fourth whistle. I'm going to release it immediately. Alright. So every second, every extra second the syrup is in the magic pot, it is going to strengthen and it is going to crumble the thing down. I mean, you know, the more stronger the syrup, the harder the katli or the burfi would get. You could mix in the dough directly in the PC itself. In that case, beware, and you should be really, really swift and very fast, because it is hot. Let me just move this down and move this aside. We don't need this anymore. I'm going to bring this here. I'm going to mix this well. And start mixing it swiftly. Make sure there are no dry parts of the flour that is left. Every single grain, every single part of the flour needs to be wet with the sugar syrup. Now mix well. As it cools down, the dough will get to harden and firm up. Okay, this is hot nut paste, so please make sure you have enough safety precautions. Mix well and aerate the dough. So as it cools, you see it is getting firmed up. See, it is getting difficult to mix. So you need to be swift and mix it really well. And you'll have to bring it to the wet chapati dough consistency. That way, it will be easy for you to roll it down and make shapes. This, if you keep doing in the magic pot, the magic pot is a super sturdy piece that will retain heat extremely well, okay? So if it is really hot, then the dough may not get cooled well, and it will take a lot of time to for the dough to set well, okay? Now I'm going to spread this on a greased, I'm going to move this aside, we don't need this anymore, okay? Now this is the 180 grams measure is going to give you a slightly sweeter version. If you want, you could go up to like 200 grams or 200 grams. So we'll start with 100 grams of dry flour. So certain flours like besan, while doing the Mysore pak, we will be needing only 100 grams of besan. Whereas while doing milk powder based katlis or burfis, we will need around 140 grams. Okay, so since this is nut based, we are going up to 180 grams. Each type of flour will behave differently. The firmer you want, the longer you cook. Consider sugar syrup to be like a glue that binds to the main ingredient. That's it. So the stronger the glue is, the harder the texture would be. Okay. Now I'm going to add a teaspoon of ghee to this. Okay. It's a bit hot. I will also add some ghee to this surface. I think by the time I added this, the ghee would have all been absorbed by the dough. Now I'm going to just roll this on this platform. It's a bit hot and just grease the balin and roll it as thin or as thick as you would. See, the dough is super pliable now. You could go for a mix of almond powder cashew powder. You could add walnut powder, pistachios, anything you like. Okay, any nut powder is going to work the same. Okay. Now that we have rolled this thin, some parts are thick, some parts are thin. I'm so sorry for that. This is the biggest possible round thing I could get, or a tray that I could get. I didn't want to use the countertop as such. Alright. Okay. Now we're going to make shapes. Go ahead, Hari. Please excuse if the shapes are not exactly as it is expected to be. So he's just going to play around. That's nice. That's okay. Whoa. No, it's okay. It's okay. That's too small. Don't stop midway. All right. Okay. Now, hold on. Okay, let me get at least a few correct pieces. Okay. Okay, I have no clue what size these things would end up in, but that's okay. It's his favorite sweet, so he gets to choose the size. Yes?
Yeah.
Okay, so now before you take this out from here, let it cool for a while. Okay, so this, I have rolled it this thin. Okay, it need not be this thin. You could just make it slightly thicker. The concept is this, it can be as pliable, it needs to be as pliable as I have shown. So it shouldn't be crumbly, it shouldn't be thick, and it shouldn't be gooey and not coming out of this platform. Okay, so it needs to be, you should be able to take the piece out from wherever you want. You see this? Yeah. So the amount of thinness or the thickness is as per your preference. Okay. Ah, there he gulped one. How is it?
Good.
Good? Alright. Okay. So there we go. OPOS Kaju Katli for you all. Thank you very much. Happy Diwali. Bye-bye.